today isn't like any other day. Today I'll be able to call my best friend, my fiance, and future wife. Before you all accompany me on this trip, I'd like to explain what today will consist of and how this day came to be. I first laid my eyes on Terencia when I was 18 years old on the campus of Florida A&M University in 2012. She attended FAMU and I attended FSU. One day I seen her on campus and she had on a stunning red dress and was the most beautiful girl I had ever seen. I was too shy to approach her at the time, but I was able to find her on Facebook through a mutual friend. We got acquainted, sparks flew, and from there, my life has never been the same. We started ring shopping a few months back, which prompted an idea to have a photo shoot where we could post pictures for our 6-year mark of union. I knew my best friend would believe that this photo shoot would be the perfect proposal opportunity, but to her disappointment, it wasn't. I told the photographer the fake that his hard drive crashed and that he lost all our pictures so that we would have to retake them. The photographer and I staged a huge argument in front of Terencia, where he offered to do another photo shoot free of charge and include a video to make up for the mishap. This was all planned so that she wouldn't know that today was her big day and to have this vital day documented without suspicion. Here's how the day would transpire. She'll begin the morning by getting a manicure and pedicure, and then she'll move on to receive a relaxing massage with her best friend. She will then head to a luxury hotel where she believes her best friend is checking in, but little does she know, I have a few surprises waiting just for her. After she has put herself together, she'll then head to the location where I'll be waiting to deliver her the biggest news yet to come. I have to admit, planning this moment has been one of the most stressful times in my life, but I wouldn't have it any other way. My beautiful black queen deserves the best and nothing less. Now that you have the backstory, welcome to the proposal. Hey, Miss Girl, how are you doing?
What's up, James?
Nothing much. How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing good. I was just calling. I just wanted to talk to you. And, you know, me and Terencia have been talking for about 6 years now. And I was trying to see how would you feel about me asking her to marry me?
Oh, God, don't make me start crying, James. Oh, my God. I'm going to start crying. Oh, my God. My Lord, yes. Oh, my God. I can't wait. Oh, man. I start crying. God,
I'm gonna ask her March 30th. Okay, well,
that's on a Saturday?
Yes, on a Saturday.
Oh, James, you already been
there,
so you just didn't even know.
I love you too. I'll keep you updated on all the details, okay?
Okay, James.
All right, make sure you don't say anything to Terencia, please.
I ain't gonna
say nothing, I promise. All righty, okay, talk to you later.
All right.
All right, love you too. Bye bye. Terencia, I know you're wondering what's going on, but before I explain, we have a few people that would like to say something.
Terencia, thank you so much for just being a supportive friend in my life, more like a sister. Since the very first day that we met, we clicked instantaneously. You have a heart of gold. You give, you love, you appreciate. You're not nasty to people, and that is so hard to find. You coming to visit me in Noble, when Noble was born, that meant the world to me. And I mean, it still means a lot to me to this very day. I am so grateful, and I am so thankful that I know you. I'm so happy to be your friend. I've watched you be faithful. You are a virtuous woman. You are everything that a man needs. And Noble says hi.
So I just wanted to let you know how much I love you so, so very much. You have literally been my bestest friend for 10 years now. And I've been so blessed to have somebody like you in my life. You are always there when I need someone to talk to or whenever I need rational advice. And I cannot thank you enough for that. You are literally the most selfless person that I know. And it's just amazing to see that you would literally give your last to somebody that you love. And I really admire that about you. So just keep doing you and being who you are. And just know that I love you so much. See you later.
Rincy. Oh, where do I start? Let's see. You were such a big crybaby. Cried about everything. But you never gave up on anything that you've ever done. Life has not always been easy. But you made it look easy. It's been a hard stride. But you stride gracefully. I'm proud of you and everything that you've ever done. I was about to cry just now. I'm gonna try not to. Role models. That's all I can say. You're a role model. You're everything that I hope my daughter looks to be one day. I love you. To the moon and back. Bye.
I just want to start this off by saying that, Rincy, you are the strongest woman that I know. And that's probably wrong to say in a lot of different ways, but to me, you are Black Girl Magic. You are the strongest woman I know. You're an amazing aunt. You're an amazing sister. You're an amazing friend. You juggle everything, and I have no clue on earth how you do that. You have an amazing job that you stay focused at. You know how to be a good girlfriend, a good aunt, a good sister. You are everything that I pray that I am and that people see me as. I love you so much. I love you because you helped me with Justin. When I was at the lowest times of my life and I wasn't vocal with anybody else in this world, you were there for me, not judging me. I honestly don't know where I would be without you, and you are everything. You're amazing, and I love you so much.
What's going on? For Rincy, same thing, man. It's like our family is a beautiful family because, shit, we ain't start out with golden spoons in our mouth or silver spoons in our mouth, but at the end of the day, it ain't about where you started from, but it's about where you headed. And you shooting for the stars, and realistically, it's an encouragement to all of us, our family. Like, we are army, and just to watch you grow with James as well. I love James too. But Rincy, it's so many stories I can tell about you that's just crazy. Like when you stole my damn car and wrecked it. But I still love you though. That's all right. That's all right. We love you. And it's a beautiful thing to watch y'all grow together.
I'll never forget my first day of high school. I was so nervous and scared. But you made sure I was okay the whole entire day. You walked me to my first period class. You made sure I didn't get lost. And that's something that I will always remember. And it's just still to this day, I'm able to look up to you as an inspiration and be so proud of you with everything that you have accomplished, because you give me hope and you give me something to look at and be and just be like, that's my sister, and I'm just so proud of you. And everything that you have accomplished is really a huge inspiration. It's really a huge inspiration, and I just want you to know that I love you so much and that I'm so proud of you. You're the best sister, and I'm so glad that I can call you my sister because I'm able to look at, up to you and want to do so much better with life. I love you so much.
In life, we're presented opportunities to encounter people and build relationships. With these relationships, people are put into our lives for a specific purpose. Some are to teach us lessons, and others come as blessings. I close my eyes and consider where I was in life before meeting you, and I realize why you were put into my life. Love. What is love? It's amazing how a four-letter word with a single syllable can be so powerful. When people speak of love, they fill its meaning with so much bliss, sometimes not mentioning the lashes that are attached. In all its glory, love is also difficult. It can be depressing in the times of adversity, troublesome when leaping hurdles to obtain new levels, gloomy in uncertainties, and at times even fearful due to commitment. How could we feel something so powerful and mass, yet it gently propels us in orbit with the thought? Despite how well love feeds the soul, its fruits are unconditionally ripe, regardless of how bad love removes all fiction from fact to implement sturdy trust. While enduring the ugly, its kindness won't let the flame of compassionate joy flicker in the strongest of winds. It alters your thought process into caring for someone more than you care for yourself without a second thought. Love isn't about finding someone you can't live with, but someone you can't live without. It's blatantly the most beautiful thing God rewarded mankind, but ultimately, with everything it has to offer, love is an indescribable feeling that can't be put into words nor defined. What happens when someone you love is put into your life? You can do one of two things: take advantage of the blessing or watch it walk away. Why would we let someone that has such an impact on our lives walk away? Maybe due to fear. Maybe they aren't ready to take the next step. Or maybe they're too blind to see what they have. The Lord says, "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." Isaiah 41:10. Life is about discovering your purpose and being able to share that purpose with someone special. At the end of the day, God makes no mistakes. When we realize why someone has been put into our lives, we can't deny it, and we must open our eyes. I've come to realize that this joining wasn't by chance. Fate intervened and brought us together. The clock is ticking and the pressure is on. It's time to make a commitment that will change our lives forever.
This is so funny. I don't even know what to say.
Yay!
I'm not afraid to die.
Come here.
This is so pretty.
Look at me. Look at me.
This is so cute. Oh, I'm gonna cry. Oh, that is so cute.
Look at me. I love you.
Oh, I love you too. This is so sweet. I love you, baby.
I love you too, baby. This is why I've been gone at work so late. Did you know what was happening at the hotel?
No, I didn't. I thought we had it. I thought we were going to go to happy hour. My nose is running.
I'll let you go.
I can't. I feel like a little
child. Look at me. It's okay.
I feel so weird. I feel so shy. I don't want to cry. Give me a hug.
You want a hug? I love you, baby.
I love you too.
It's been a long time coming. It's okay. So, I'll fix this real quick. Might as well. So, I would take...
Oh, I got something.
It's okay. Here. So, the very first picture that we ever took is the one that you see here. And if you remember, we took this exact same picture on this day 6 years ago, March 30th, 2013. From that picture until now, we've been through a lot. We've grown together. We've traveled together. We've fought together. We've loved together. We've done everything together. You're the love of my life, and I commit to do everything possible to make you the happiest person on earth.
Thank you.
You're my best friend. You're my everything.
I love you.
And I love you so much.
I love you too.
So with that being said, I won't make you wait much longer. Terencia, Shaquan, and Bambi.
Baby, it's so pretty! It's so pretty! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! It's so pretty! It's so pretty!
Y'all could come.
I'm latching on to you.